Everyone, today I'll be talking about the most commonly used and fundamental tools in Adobe Illustrator. So let's go. So this is how it looks when you open Adobe Illustrator. You'll find all your previous works here. You can open those files to edit them or continue the work from here itself, or if you want to open a new project, so you can select from some options given here, or else you can go to File, click on New, and a window appears here with lots of presets and resolutions of the artboard. You can select any of them. Let's go with this. Let's go with the A4 size. You can choose any of them. So this is the interface. You will find all the tools on your left hand side. Let's start up. So the first and most important thing on Illustrator is the layer panel. So you'll get all the panels on your right hand side to adjust them. So this is the layer panel. If you don't find it on your screen, you can go to Windows, and you can get all the panels you want here. Select on, click on layers, so you'll get it. So this is the eye tool, so you can hide your artboard. If you want to unhide it, click again. You can also lock the layers so that you don't draw on them mistakenly. So if you want to add layers, you can add as many as you want, like this. All the layers will be represented by different colors, so you can lock all of them, you can unlock all of them. You can also create a sub layer like this by clicking the option next to the layer option. You have a create new sub layer. So on the create new sub layer, you can create another layer. You can create as many layers you want inside a layer and also on the artboard. So let's select a layer and let's move this on the right hand side. You can move them wherever you want. Let's go to the tools. So if you want to move your artboard up and down, you can use the scrolling button on your mouse. And if you want to zoom in, you can press Control plus on your keyboard and Control minus. Those are the shortcuts for zoom. And if you want to move the artboard around, press space, click and move. You can pan in with that. So okay, the next tool is the pen tool. So here's a pen tool. This is the pen tool and this is curvature tool. Don't get confused, they both look the same, but this is the pen tool. You can see the small box saying pen tool there. So let's look at the pen tool. With the help of pen tool, you can draw straight lines like this. If you want to undo an action, press Ctrl and Z. So the next tool is direct selection tool. This is direct selection tool, and the keyboard shortcut for it is A. So with the help of direct selection tool, you can select the objects or selection of some particular parts of your artwork. So let me show you. Let's go to pen tool and I'll make a shape. Now click on direct selection tool, so you can move it, you can move the shape, you can round the corners like this, you can round them individually or all at the same time, and you can also move them. If you click on the path, if you click on the path, you can move the whole path or you can change the shape of it like this. And if you click on the anchor, only that anchor moves like this. And if you click on path, all the anchors which are connected to that path moves along with it. So this is what selection tool, direct selection tool does. And you can also select like this, and if you want to delete it, press delete on your keyboard. Don't find brush tool on your toolbox, it is under this pencil tool. We'll have to click it, right click on the pencil tool, so we'll find different types of tools here, like pencil tool, blob brush tool and paint brush tool. So let's go to paint brush tool. Let's select the color. Like this. And if you want to erase it, you can go to eraser tool or press shift plus E. If you want to increase the size of the eraser, double click on the eraser tool and you will find the size here. Like this. If you want to change the settings of your paintbrush, double click on the paintbrush and you will find it here, and you'll find the settings here. This is fidelity. So what this does is this smoothens your strokes. Like if you put it on accurate and press OK, show you how. If you draw any stroke, it will be the same way how you draw it. And if you put the fidelity on smooth, then it will smoothen your strokes like this. If you put it on accurate, and when you put it on smooth, it automatically smoothens the path. So let's select all of them and delete. Let's zoom out. Next tool is pencil tool. Right click on the paintbrush tool, go to pencil tool. Or the shortcut for the pencil tool is N on your keyboard. The same thing applies for the pencil tool also. You can choose the fidelity like accurate or smooth. See? And the next tool is text. You can add text to your work like this. And we can move it with the help of direct selection tool. When you click on the text with the direct selection tool, a toolbar comes above like this. You can change the size of the text here. And you can change the fonts from here. You can also change the color of the text. And the next important tool on Illustrator is eyedropper tool. So what eyedropper tool does is, when you make a shape or when you're doing something, you want to change the color of that. So now I want to change the color of this shape to this color, this blue color. So what I'll do is select the one which I want to change, go to eyedropper tool and click on the color I want to change. That's it. So this is how you change the color with the help of eyedropper tool. And you can also place any photos on your artboard, and you can choose a color from that photo which you can use on your artboard. And the next tool is rectangle tool. So this is rectangle tool. There are a lot of options like rectangle tool, ellipse, polygon, star and line segment tool. Let's go one by one. Let's go with that. So rectangle tool, click anywhere, drag. This is how I make a rectangle. And if you want star tool, you can increase or decrease any number of corners you want by pressing arrow key. If you press upwards, it will increase, and if you press down, it will decrease, which is very helpful to make a triangle. And this is ellipse tool. The same thing goes with the polygon tool also. You can increase the number of sides by pressing upward arrow button. So these are the basic tools in the Adobe Illustrator. So after all this, when you want to save the file, click on file, click on export, click export as, and you can rename it anything and export. Click on export. You can increase the quality of your image. I'll keep it on maximum. Click OK. And that's it. These are the basic tools of Adobe Illustrator. Thank you for watching. I hope you subscribe. Thank you.